Dear friends, this is the Abhidhamma lesson after the introduction. In the former lessons, we have explained the background of Abhidhamma. Now we have to enter the philosophy of Abhidhamma. But before that, we have to understand the Abhidhammic teachings in accordance with the suttas, because Abhidhammic teachings means nothing else what we find in the suttas. And also, if we understand Abhidhamma in relation to the suttas, then we can easily understand its interconnection. That now we see in the Dharma schools and in the schools or in the universities, we study Chitta Chetasika Rupa Nibbana, four realities. Chitta means consciousness, Chetasika means mental concomitants or thoughts, Rupa means matter or material elements, Nibbana means emancipation. Then, when we study these things as separate elements, we cannot understand, because we cannot understand its basis. Therefore, I think we have to understand these realities in relation to the basic teachings of the suttas. Therefore, we can understand easily the five grasping groups or five aggregates, what we call rupa. Rupa, Vedana, Sanya, Sankhara, Vinyana. These are called five aggregates. So, really, they are called Pancha Upadana Skandha. Pancha Upadana Kanda, five grasping groups. Because they are called grasping because we have taken them as mind, Upadana. We have grasped them as mind and I. Therefore, they are really called in relation to the person five grasping groups. But for easy understanding, easy usage, I will use five aggregates. However, I will tell one thing, because when we study Chitta Chetasika Rupa in Abhidhamma, we think that they are something new, something new. No, actually they are based on the Sutta teachings. Let us say like this, Rupa means in Abhidhamma 28 material elements. Chatu Attavisati Rupa. In Abhidhamma, you know, there are 28 material elements are explained. They are nothing. This rupa. And Vedana means feelings. Feelings are taken as one item. Sanya also is taken as one item. Vedana means feeling or sensations. Sanya means perception. I think you can remember, if you have gone through the lists of Abhidhamma in the Chetasikas, among the 52 Chetasikas, the first group is Sabba Chitta Sadharana, common thoughts. That means Passa, Vedana, Sanya, Chetana, Ekagata, Jivitindriya, Manasikara. You find these two among them. And Sankhara means dispositions. They have been analyzed into 50 in Abhidhamma. Then, collectively, this Vedana, Sanya and Sankhara together, 52, we call them Chetasika. Chetasikas means mental concomitants or thoughts, right? This is we call, Rupa means matter. Matter. Then Vijnana is taken as Chitta. Chitta means consciousness. It has been divided into 89 or 121 parts in Abhidhamma. Now you can understand the relationship between the early Buddhist teaching or Sutta teaching, five aggregates, and how these five aggregates are analyzed into Abhidhammic paramarthas or realities. There are material elements and immaterial, or otherwise we call it conditioned elements and unconditioned elements. In Abhidhamma, among the four realities, Chitta, Chetasika, Rupa are conditioned elements because they change according to the cause and effect theory. But Nibbana is called unconditioned reality. It does not change. But here we are talking about the conditioned elements. Sankhara and Asankhara. Asankhara, Sankhata and Asankhata. Sankhata means conditioned elements. Then all these three realities are conditioned. Asankhata Paramattha means Nibbana. Right? Then you see, then these five aggregates are explained in many suttas, but don't think that we find only the five aggregates. This is called analysis. Right? This analysis, and there is another thing what we call synthesis. These two things should be understood very well. Because in the Buddha's time, in the 6th century in India, there were many religious and philosophical traditions. Buddha has classified them into two main streams. They are called extremist views, Sassatavada and Ucchedavada, eternalism and nihilism. Sassatavada is so called because they believed in an eternal entity, maybe soul or Brahman or something else. And in the materialistic traditions, they believed that Patavi, Apo, Tejo, Vayo, Earth, Water, Fire and Air, Sukha, Dukkha, Jiva, Suffering, Happiness and Soul. These are eternal. Some people believed consciousness is eternal. Some people believed that soul is eternal. Some people believed that four great elements or five great elements are eternal, like that. Then Buddha wanted to explain according to the real nature of the world, that means impermanent, suffering and soulless. According to the real nature of the world, everything is impermanent. But no one accepts this saying without proving. Then Buddha had to prove that everything is impermanent. Then what is the method that Buddha used? The method of analysis. Buddha analyzed everything into pieces. Mental and physical aspects of the life have been analyzed. Then we find many analyses in the suttas. Name and form, five aggregates, four great elements, and 12 bases, 18 elements, etc. You know, Patavi, Apo, Tejo, Vayu, earth, water, fire and air. It's a four great element into four. Then five aggregates, Rupa, Vedana, Sanya, Sankara, Vijnana. And also 12 bases, Chakku, Sota, Gana, Jivaha, Kaya, Mana, eye, ear, nose, tongue, skin, and mind. And also forms, sounds, smell, taste, touch, etc. And also 18 elements, Chakku, Rupa, Chakku, Vijnana, eye, form and eye consciousness, ear, sounds and ear consciousness, etc. Then you know why these analyses are available in many suttas. Because the main point is to prove that there is no any eternal essence, eternal thing inside the mental or physical world. That is why Buddhism rejected the view of eternalism by means of analysis, by the method of analysis. That is why we find many parts. Therefore, someone may come to the wrong view that, oh, there are many lists. Therefore, Buddhism is a pluralism. No. It doesn't matter. Because, again, Buddha has used the central philosophy of Buddhism, what we call cause and effect theory, or dependent co-origination, paticca samuppada. According to that, Buddha has shown the interrelationship as causes and effects, these factors, these things which have been analyzed come into existence again and again due to the cause and effect theory. Then that is called synthesis. Then what happens, you know, when Buddha proved that everything arises again and again, vanishes again and again, and but they come into being again and again, then continuity is proved. Then there was another wrong view at the time of the Buddha called nihilism. Then nihilism was rejected by using the method of synthesis, paticca samuppada. Now you see, by means of analysis, Buddha rejected eternalism. By means of synthesis, Buddha rejected the nihilism. Then by avoiding or rejecting these two extremist views of the religious and philosophical traditions, Buddha established the middle path. Middle path is based on middle view. Middle view means nothing else, paticca samuppada, dependent co-origination. Then middle path is the Noble Eightfold Path, which consists of three main stages: sila, samadhi, panya, morality, concentration, and wisdom. Now you can understand. Then you see, although there are many such analyses, I have selected only five aggregates, because throughout the history, many scholars have paid much attention to this analysis. It covers everything. For example, if we analyze rupa, we can get patavya poteju vayu, four great elements. Also, we can take chakku sota gana jivha kaya. All are belonging to the rupa. But you know this, here in this analysis, mentality is given a prominent place, because mind has been analyzed into four aspects: Vedana, Sanya, Sankara, Vijnana. But Rupa is so, matter is taken as one item. But however, many Abhidhammic analyses are based on these five aggregates. That is why it is important, because Rupa is taken as matter into 28 material elements. Vedana, Sanya, Sankhara are taken as 52 Chetasikas, so mental concomitants. Vijnana is taken as Chitta and analyzed into 121 parts. But remember, these five aggregates, because represent the Abhidhammic three realities, Chitta, Chetasika, and Rupa. Then, once we understand the five aggregates fully, then we can understand the Chitta, Chetasika, Rupa also correctly. Therefore, I think we need to understand five aggregates clearly, fully, in order to understand the Chitta, Chetasika, Rupa. Otherwise, if we start Chitta, how many? 89 or 100. Then we are bewildered. What are we talking? Where are we going? Therefore, I think we have to understand first the five aggregates which appear in the suttas clearly should be understood. Then only we can understand Abhidhamma clearly. In the next lesson, we will go to that. Thank you.